In this video tutorial, you will learn how to create an email signature for free in Canva. First, I'll show you how you can create a custom email signature in Canva. And if you watch this video until the end, I'll also share a bonus tip to add clickable links in your email signature. So make sure you watch until the end. Well, this is the custom email signature I have created in Canva. And let me show you how you can create the same. So first, go to canva.com, simply type canva.com in your browser field and hit enter. And when you are on the canva.com, the first thing you need to do is you need to create a design. So simply click on this, and from here you need to select the various dimension options that are already available here. But since email signature is not here, so I'll simply choose custom size and enter a custom size that is 400 by 200. And then from this drop-down menu, select PX, which stands for pixels. Here you can also see that it is suggesting this 400 into 200 PX for email signature. Once you have entered that, simply click on create new design. And this will open a new canvas here with size 400 and 200 px. The first thing we are going to do is we will add an element here, and for that we will simply click on this elements tab and then select a shape in the circular form, which is this one. So click on this and this will be here on the canvas. Now I'll just change the color of this shape. For that I'll click on this color option and select this color. Next, I just want to add an image placeholder here. For that, I'll go to elements again and just find the frame option. Here we go. In the frames, you can see this circular frame. So I'll simply select this and this will be here. I'll just resize this by pinching from the corner, so that it should look like a circular border like this. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add my logo here. For that, I'll go to upload section where I have already added my image logo, this one, and drag it over to the frame area like this. By the way, if you have a larger image size, you may also double click on this and adjust it to fit into the frame like this. But in my case, it's perfect with this default size. So I'll keep it just like that and then click this done option. The next thing I'm going to do is I will just resize this, and for that I'll simply select both of these items and pinch from the corner like this. The reason why I selected both of these items because I want to move both of them or resize both of them simultaneously. I'll just drag it over to this area. And now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add other details of my signature, like my name, my organization name, my designation, and my contact details, etc. But before that, I will just add some border near the corners so that I know the exact position where I want to keep these other details. So let me just go to elements area, and from here I'll select a line option like this. I'll simply drag it and place near this area near the top, and then I'll simply select the corner and drag it to increase the size, and make sure it is angled at 0 degree so that it is straight line. And once that is done, I'll simply click on this and change the color of this line. I'll keep this one so that it matches the other elements on this image. Now it's time to add this line as border on other corners as well, like on the left, right, and bottom. One way we can do that is by repeating the same process again, but To save time, I'm just going to right click on this and then copy this, and then I'll just press the universal keyboard shortcut for paste, which is Command plus V, and this has pasted the same border line here. I'll just move this from here and place it to the right position like this. I'll again press the Command plus V to paste this, and this time I'm going to rotate its angle like this, and then I'll reposition it to this area. Once again, I'll just press Command plus V and then rotate the angle like this, and when the angle is 90 degrees and it is straight aligned, I'll simply reposition it to this right side area. So now we have got a fine border near the corners, and that is why we know which area we have to stay inside. Now the next step is to add names and other details. For that, I'll simply go to text options here in the menu and select this add a heading option, and then I'll simply just enter my name here. By the way, from here, these options, you may also change font. I'll go with this one and increase or decrease the font size along with changing the text color. And once you are happy with this, simply drag it like this to reposition it. Next, I'm going to add another text here and add a subheading. For that, I'll first make it bold and then I'll enter text here. Now I'll just resize it, and then I'm going to add a background behind this text area. For that, I'll go to elements option again and select a shape, this one, and I'll just resize it like this. Further, let me just change the color of this text. This one looks good. Let me also increase the size of text a bit. I'll select the behind layer and then resize it. So far, this looks good. I'll just drag it on the top a bit to increase the spacing between these two. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add website detail. For that, I'll simply type website in the elements section and hit enter. Here you can see this is available for free, so I'll use this one, and then I'll resize it like this and then reposition it so that it is aligned in a straight line. Next, I'm going to add my website address here. So for that, I'm simply going to add a text option here and add a subheading. I'll first make it bold and then reposition it by dragging like this, and then enter my website address, which is this one. But as you can see, this website address detail is just overlapping my icon here. So I'll simply drag it like this to fix this, and then add a background behind this. For that, I'll simply go to elements again, and here let me just clear that and select a shape here, and this time I'm going to resize it behind this. I'll also change the text color on this one to this, and then change the background color to this. This is pretty good so far. I'll just increase the size a bit, and then I'm going to add my other contact details like social media. For that, I'll simply add social media icons like Facebook and you just have to type Facebook in the elements search field and hit enter. This one is free, so we are going to use this one. This is pretty large, so I'll just resize it and then place it here. I'll add another one. Let's get this one. Just resize it and place it next to Facebook. Let's add this one as well and then resize it and repeat the process like this. Also this one. Alright, we have added social media icons and so far it looks quite good. Next, we are going to add our social media user handle by simply going to text area and then adding a subheading. Just reposition it here and let me enter my user handle. I'll just reposition it like this and then add a background behind this as well. For that, we will go to elements section again and let's just clear this search field and then choose a shape. Let's resize it and then place it behind this. I'll change the color of this text to this one. So far this looks good. Let me just fix this one before we are ready to export it, and this should be aligned next to the text like this. And once you are happy with your design, it's time to download this email signature and add it in your Gmail. So simply click on the download in the top right area and simply download it in the PNG format. Let me rename it. As Rahul email signature and then just click save. And this has been downloaded on my computer. Now that we have created our email signature in Canva, it's time to add clickable links in your email signature. For that, let me show you how you can do that in Gmail. Let me just go to Gmail and here in the top right area, you can see there is settings like cog icon. Simply click on that and then you will get the option to see all settings. You just have to click on this and this will load all the settings of your Gmail. Under the general tab, simply scroll down until you see signature. And here we go. Here you can see the signature option and there is no signatures right now. So I'll simply click on create new and then I'll add a signature name. And then click create. Next, I'll just click on this image icon and insert an image. I'm going to upload an image by simply dragging a file here. I'll just drag this recently created email signature that we created in Canva for free and release it here. And it'll start uploading. So this is it. We have just uploaded a custom email signature in Gmail and we are going to make it clickable by adding a link. So I'll simply select this and then click this link icon and enter a URL here. I'll keep this empty, and then press OK. So we have just added clickable link in the email signature. It's time to save it. That is, click on this save changes button to save all settings, otherwise your changes would be lost. So that is how you can create an email signature in Canva for free. I hope you found this video helpful. If yes, please hit the like button to let me know and subscribe for more such updates. Thanks for watching. I'm Rahul signing off, and I'll see you in the next video.